Let's go to Steve Kornacki. Steve,
what a night.
About a crazy night.
Here you go. And this is what the result is. As you say, the Republican Glenn Youngkin pulling out the victory in Virginia. A year ago at this time, we were talking about how Virginia had gone blue, had gone for Joe Biden by double digits, by 10 points. Now the Republican by 2 points over Terry McAuliffe. How did Youngkin do it? Well, the simplest answer is he made everything a little bit less blue. He made everything a little bit more red. We can show you the results here compared to 2020. The more red it is, the bigger the bubble it is, the more Republican improvement it is. You can see pretty much everywhere here on the map you have Republican improvement, but a couple of areas jump out here. We'll pull this right off the screen. Number one, you look in the Hampton Roads area, you look in Virginia Beach. We talked yesterday. This was the closest thing I think there was to kind of a bellwether in the state, the city of Virginia Beach. This is one of the big, this is the biggest independent city in Virginia demographically. This is one of those places that's a pretty good combination of every group in the state there. So it's a pretty good representation of the state. It's a place that Joe Biden had won. Youngkin's campaign said they wanted to win it back. They won it back. They won it back by 8 points. Same thing happened right next door in the city of Chesapeake. These were sort of bellwether areas. Youngkin won them back. He won them back by a solid margin, too. The other thing that Glenn Youngkin did, we talked about the suburbs of Washington, D.C. Could he make inroads? Not necessarily win, but could he win back some of the voters that the Republican Party had abandoned in the suburbs of Northern Virginia, in the suburbs of Virginia during the Trump presidency? Here's Fairfax County. It's the biggest one in the state on paper. Oh, geez, Youngkin got slaughtered in Fairfax County. Well, he did. He lost by 30 points to Terry McAuliffe, but he didn't get slaughtered as much as Donald Trump did. This was a 42-point loss for Donald Trump last year in the biggest county in Virginia, right outside Washington, D.C. Youngkin was able to take that back 12 points. You see, if you go back to the last election pre-Trump, when Mitt Romney was running, he was able to get closer to where Romney ran here, although he didn't. You see, he didn't actually get back to that Romney number. So, yeah, if he wasn't getting to Romney numbers in the suburbs of Northern Virginia, and remember, Romney lost statewide, what was the other ingredient to this last night for Youngkin? Well, he made inroads in the suburbs, he won the bellwethers, and then he met and then exceeded Donald Trump's total of the vote all throughout rural Virginia. And this was the other question mark, because there are places here, I think we showed you yesterday morning, let's revisit it right now. It's a small one, but it's a story we see in a whole bunch of these different small red counties on the map right here. Allegheny County, just check out the story of the last couple of election cycles here. Go all the way back to 2012. This was a toss-up. Mitt Romney won this county by just a couple of points in 2012. Along came Donald Trump. This is the kind of place, rural, blue-collar, non-college-educated white voters. This is sort of Appalachia. Donald Trump did extremely well here. It was not guaranteed coming into this election that Youngkin could do what Trump had did. Youngkin did what Trump had did, and look at that. He actually builds it a 50-point victory for Youngkin in a county that just 9 years ago, Republicans were winning by 3 points. So he locked in, Youngkin did, the Trump surge in rural Virginia, in southwest Virginia. He made inroads in the suburbs, and as we say, he won those bellwethers, and there it is, a state that last year was 10 points for Joe Biden. Now, a Republican win.
Let's talk about New Jersey real quick. It's very tight race. It does look like the votes outstanding are in Murphy's category, but this is a state Biden won by 16 points. Democrats really should be concerned that it's as close this morning.
Yeah, I mean, you talk about close in our tally right now. There it is. 61 votes at this hour separating Jack Cittarelli, the Republican challenger, Phil Murphy, the Democratic incumbent. That's come down from about 500 2 hours or so ago. So Murphy keeps getting closer. He hasn't caught him yet. But as you mentioned, this is what New Jersey looked like in the 2020 presidential election. 16-point Biden win. New Jersey hasn't gone Republican in a presidential race since back in 1988. You know, Chris Christie won the governor's race twice in New Jersey. Otherwise, there's not much much to show for Republicans in statewide campaigns in New Jersey this century. If you talk to even Republicans in New Jersey the week before this campaign, they were not giving you much in terms of Chitterelli's chances. They were saying, hey, maybe we keep this under 10. Maybe we can do okay in the state legislature. Instead, as you say, here's Chitterelli right now still actually leading in the vote tally. Now, where is the remaining vote here? One thing that we've been following, and I'm not sure when today, we hope today we will get this, Mercer County. This is a fairly good-sized county. This is where Trenton is, the state capital. Princeton's down here. This is a Democratic county. I can just show you how Democratic. It's the kind of county that Joe Biden won by 40 points in 2020. What we are missing in Mercer County is critical here, I think. It's the vote by mail. The mail ballots. And the mail ballots in New Jersey, it's true in every state. We keep talking about this. Heavily, overwhelmingly, we're talking like 80% Democratic. So when you get the vote by mail in Mercer County, I think there's an expectation that Phil Murphy going to pad the lead he has in Mercer County. That would certainly give him the opportunity to leapfrog, to catapult over Chitterelli in a statewide count. We also believe there are still some precincts to report out yesterday's Election Day vote in Essex County. This is Newark. This is the area immediately around Newark. This is the biggest Democratic vote-producing county in New Jersey. Some of the precincts within this county are extremely, extremely Democratic. So if a few of those are still outstanding, again, there's a chance for Murphy to net some votes there. We also think there may be some votes to come here in Somerset County. This is actually Jack Chitterelli's home county. You see Chitterelli leading in the tally here right now. Again, we think there may be some early vote or some mail vote. Either way, that's a more Democratic friendly type of vote left here. So you can find pockets like this on this map where it looks like Murphy has opportunities to get ahead. You could see a path there for Murphy. And you can't find comparably pockets on this map right now for Chitterelli. But the one thing I would just say is, and this is the one thing Democrats and the Republicans I talked to last night agreed on in New Jersey, they were both baffled with and frustrated by the vote reporting coming out of these counties. Very, very unclear, even to these parties last night in New Jersey, exactly where the remaining vote was.
So New Jersey's too close to call again, a state that Joe Biden won by 16 points. Steve, I'm going to ask you to hop back to Virginia and look at some of the issues out of our exit polling, what people voted on. Glenn Youngkin, who won this race, made it all about education. His rallies were called Parents Matter. He was speaking to the curriculum in the schools. He was speaking to some of these schools being closed for well over a year and the frustration that parents had. So what did people vote on in Virginia, Steve?
Yeah, I'm seeing if I can call it up here, and it's unfortunately the graphic doesn't seem to be loading, but we asked in the poll, what do you consider to be the most important issue in the exit poll? What do you consider to be the most important issue? The economy actually topped the list, but not far behind it. About a quarter of all voters, 24%, identified education as their top issue in this race. Folks who picked education went for Youngkin by a pretty solid margin. So again, focal point of Youngkin's campaign. That actually, the county, you mentioned the rally, the what he called the Parents Matter rally that Youngkin closed his campaign with. And his campaign thought Loudoun County would be the epicenter of that in particular. Again, D.C. metro area. Here you go. McAuliffe is going to win this by 10.5 points. The Youngkin campaign believed that issue of education would have resonance in the suburbs and really in Loudoun County. And again, check this out. This was a 25-point massacre for Joe Biden and for the Democrats a year ago. 25-point win. Youngkin doesn't win it, but look at that. He brings it all the way down to basically 10 points in Loudoun County. And again, one of the things he was trying to do, he was trying to rewind the clock. He was trying to get, Youngkin was, get Republicans back closer to where they were in the suburbs before Donald Trump came along. Again, he did not get them all the way back. Look at this. Mitt Romney was only 4 points behind in Loudoun County when he was running. Youngkin didn't get them all the way back there, but he got them close enough where, again, if you supplement that surge Trump vote that he was able to hold on to and actually build on, that's sort of a new combination. You know, we've seen different candidates win Virginia different ways in the past. Here's one. Youngkin didn't get the traditional kind of old school Republican strength in the suburbs, but he got a little bit, and then he supplemented it with strength they hadn't seen before Donald Trump in the rural parts of the state. And that, in this case, is what adds up to this.
Wow. All right, Steve Kornacki, we're going to get to the other races in just a little bit.
Hey, thanks so much for watching our YouTube channel. You can follow up on today's top stories and breaking news or catch up on your favorite MSNBC shows all in one place. Download the NBC News app today.